the plant chemical diversity is massive, and we are only using a small part of it. So how can we make the most of it, preserving the genetic and natural resources? Instead of growing plants in the field and using arable lands, we are using the unique ability of plants to dedifferentiate their tissue cells into a kind of stem cells. And these cells, we are able to grow them into bioreactor, and they have also the ability to produce the molecule of interest that we found earlier in the plants. As soon as we obtain the cells on solid medium, we transfer them into liquid medium to make them grow more efficiently into bioreactor and starting the process optimization.
So in this lab, what we do is we make the link between the calli production, the calli turn into cell cultures, liquid cell cultures, and these liquid cell cultures then have to be upscaled. So we have several units of bioreactors here. In these units, what we do is we try to optimize the conditions that we have. So we try to find the best balance in terms of, for example, temperature, agitation, pH, in order to get the most cost-efficient production of molecules.
After the optimization of the parameters for the culture of the plant cell suspensions, then we are going into this room to make the upscaling. So from the 4 liters, we will then go to the 30 liters, and the 30 liters will be used to seed the 300 liters. With this, we will reach the pre-industrial scale, and this is where we have this niche that allows us to go quite close to the market.
So using these facilities, we are able to calculate key data such as the cost efficiency of our product, and also to validate that these processes are transferable to industrial partners. We are mainly targeting sectors such as the cosmetics, the nutraceuticals, the pharmaceuticals, the food, and also the agrochemistry. So with this technology, we are able to produce new molecules of interest with really high added value, and to provide to our partners niche markets that are not available for other partners.